I will chant Om Namah Shivaya twice. Please repeat after me. Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Shivaya. Om Namah 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 Shivaya.
We are all assembled here in this beautiful place, surrounded by nature with all its beauty, serenity. I am in the midst of nature, in the beauty and serenity of nature. That beauty, that serenity, that liveliness represents my own nature. The reason why I feel so good in presence of nature is because I experience a harmony. I am brought in touch with my own true nature of peace and harmony and serenity. That is the magic that the nature has. And that is why an environment like this makes it somewhat easy for me to see my true nature as peace, beauty, serenity. What is the truth of nature? Is the truth of myself? Is the truth of everything? That is the truth. That is the harmony. That is the cord that connects everything. Even though outwardly there may appear to be discord, disharmony, conflict, that is only superficial. In nature as well as in myself. In nature also I often see storms, earthquakes, volcanoes, hurricanes, looks like nature is very harsh, but that is only incidental. In spite of that outer appearance of harshness, nature, which is a manifestation of Ishvara, is all harmony, beauty, serenity in its core. And so also often I find in myself storms, volcanoes, earthquakes, hurricanes. I see those things in myself also. Sometimes anger, sometimes jealousy, sometimes frustration, sometimes sadness, stress, anxiety. Sometimes I feel that that is my nature. Fear, anxiety is my nature, so it looks to me like. But that is not my nature. All of that is superficial, incidental. And that is why we require a place like this, which is a strong influence in me, and it quietens those disturbances. An environment like this enables me to experience my mind. Which enjoys peace and serenity. Peace, serenity, beauty is my nature. If there are opposite tendencies, such as aggressiveness, such as anger, frustration, all of those are the products of ignorance. Not knowing the true nature of myself. Not knowing the true nature of the world. In this meditation, we begin by reminding ourselves that we have no agenda. At this time, I have no agenda. Nothing to achieve, nothing to accomplish, nothing to prove. At this time, I'm not seeking anybody's approval. I'm not seeking anybody's acceptance. Because I know that peace, beauty, serenity which is what I'm seeking is in fact my own nature. It is the achievement of what is already achieved. And therefore, there is nothing I have to achieve in life. I am what I am seeking to be. and therefore I give up all anxieties. And worries about becoming something else. I do not have to become other than what I am, because I am self-sufficient as I am. In spite of all the limitations of my body, in spite of all the limitations of the mind, in spite of all the shortcomings in my personality, in spite of many unfulfilled desires and ambitions, in spite of all of them, I am a complete being. Those inadequacies do not belong to me. The inadequacies belong to my body. The body is birth and death. The body is constantly changing. The body has limitations of strength and skills. They are all the limitations of the body. Mind also is limited. Limited in its capacity to understand. Limited in memories. Limited in capacity to reproduce. Limited in many ways. All those limitations belong to the mind. But the limitations of the body, the limitations of the mind do not affect me. Because I am not the body. I am not the mind. Even as I am saying this, I recognize that I am aware of this body. The body is the object of my awareness. The body, with all its limitations, is an object of my awareness, object of my knowledge. I am the awareer of the body. I am the knower of the body. Therefore, I am distinct from the body. The limitations of the body do not belong to me, nor does it affect me. I am the subject. The body is the object. The object does not in any way affect the subject. Similarly also, the mind is object of my awareness. Mind with various thoughts and emotions and memories all of those are objects of my awareness. They're objects of my knowledge. I am the subject that illumines all the thoughts, all the emotions, all the memories. And the illuminator is never affected by what is illumined. I, the illuminator, the conscious being, am ever unaffected, untouched, untainted by the characteristics and limitations of the body-mind complex. Body is no doubt beautiful. It's a great gift from Ishvara. Nevertheless, I am not the body. The mind also is a wonderful gift from Ishvara. In spite of that, I am not the mind. I am not the characteristics or the limitations of the mind. I am a plain, simple, conscious being. Unaffected, untainted serenity, beauty, peace is indeed my nature. When the mind is at peace, when the mind is abiding, then it becomes an appropriate instrument for manifesting my true nature of peace, beauty, serenity. In spite of the world being what it is, in spite of my life being what it is, in spite of people around me being what they are, in spite of my body being what it is, in spite of my mind being what it is, in spite of anything and everything being what it is, I am self-sufficient, self-existent. Self-effulgent. Not even conscious being, the consciousness I am. Chidananda Rupah Shivoham Shivoham Chidananda Rupah Shivoham Shivoham. Chidananda Rupah Shivoham Shivoham Chidananda Rupah Shivoham Shivoham. peace, beauty, tranquility, joy. That is what Lord Shiva manifests.
On the serene face of Lord Shiva
is evident a gentle smile. Which manifests the inner purity, serenity, peace, joy. That is my nature. Shivoham, that Shiva I am.
Chit Ananda.
Chit self shining, self effulgent. Ananda self sufficient.
All the insufficiencies are incidental.
They belong to the non-self.
The self in the midst of all insufficiencies is self-sufficient,
eliminating all insufficiencies
of the body-mind complex.
Chidananda-rupa Shivoham
Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.